was watching a pregame skate, Doc, and his teammates were having a little fun with the youngster. He was out there all alone during the pregame skate. This is how his teammates say, "Welcome to the league, kid."
Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to NHL 17 Be a Pro with Russ Courtnall. He is about to make his NHL debut. Sure, he's played some preseason games, but they're going to count starting tonight against the Boston Bruins. Columbus will be at home to start the season, and the nerves have to be high for young Russ Courtnall.
Hi, everyone. With Eddie Olczyk alongside and Ray Ferraro down at the ice, this is Mike Emery. These are two teams from the East. Our game is between the Columbus Blue Jackets and the Bruins. For thoughts on the game, here's Eddie.
We saw these opening night rosters slowly develop during the preseason. These are the players that the teams are going to go to battle with. It's the start of another great season of hockey, playoff-like atmosphere, Doc.
Okay, so we've set the scene for Russ Courtnall's very first NHL game. Now let's get him on the ice here. Oh. As he goes off the ice on his first shift, the Bruins score a goal. Bad timing right there. We may have left somebody open to get that puck and score. It's Patrice Bergeron who's going to get the goal, first of the season for either one of these teams, drawing first blood, getting that past Bobrovsky and making it 1-0. So hopefully it wasn't Courtnall's guy, but he was gassed, trying to do the right thing, get off the ice. It didn't work right there. So 1-0 Boston. About midway through the first, Columbus looking for the equalizer. Oh, that gets through Courtnall and goes to the corner. But they are forechecking aggressively here, keeping it in the zone. Courtnall trying to work in front, be a pest, maybe get a tip. No, instead he's going to get that back to the point. Great puck control by Columbus, but they need shots on goal. Just not getting it there. And that puck is eventually cleared.
I was watching a pregame skate, Doc, and his teammates were having a little fun with the youngster. He was out there all alone during the pregame skate. This is how his teammates say, "Welcome to the league, kid."
So there may not have been a drastic overhaul of Be A Pro this year, but I like that they've added the elements here in both Be A Pro and in your franchise that will recognize first games. When you're getting pranked like that, sent out on the ice for the skate all alone. Oh, there's a goal. We've got a goal and we got a tie game. Off the faceoff, Courtnall darts in front trying to get a tip. He does not do that, but the puck is put in the net either way. And that's Ryan Murray's first of the year. Of course it is. It's first goal for Columbus, period, this year. You see Courtnall going in front there where he might be able to get a tip. Not this time, but it's not needed. Puck in the net. And it's 1-1 as Columbus ties this thing up. We go to further action, and Boston scores as Courtnall sitting on the bench. So it's now 2-1, and we are more than halfway through this game, midway through the second period. Big hit right there, keeping the puck in, loses his lid, and oh, what a chance for Courtnall. Can't put it home. It would have been his first NHL goal. Nice save, but oh, man. Getting rocked right here. Let's watch the replay. Boom! Big shoulder into it there. Lid goes flying. Yeah, that's aggressive play right there, and it leads directly to a scoring chance that they almost buried. So trying to get this game tied again. Again, working in front, but he's tied up. Can't really get a shot off properly. We're still at 2-1. Here's another faceoff win. Can they get a goal? They're buzzing. And no, another save. And just trying to kind of be physical here and show a presence. I wasn't really trying to actually initiate a fight, and that's what ended up happening. So a little overboard there, chewing off a little more than he'd like at this point here. Courtnall's not a fighter. You know, he'll stand up and do it once in a while, and obviously we didn't have a choice here because I was just trying to basically pester the guy and ended up initiating a fight, and we lose that fight. So, lesson learned here for the young rookie. He earned some respect from his teammates for standing up right there. My guess is he probably also earned a shiner in the process here as he gets drilled and put to the ice. Yeah, he looks a little dazed and confused after that fight. Like, what did I just get myself into? But that's okay. He goes to the box for a while. He feels shame. And then he returns. So here we go in the third period now, trying to rush up ice, get into the play, asking for the puck. Great spot right there, but no. Stopped again. Still looking for that first NHL goal. Thought he Might have had it there. It was a glorious look. Here he gets a tip, and that one won't go in either. He did get the deflection going to the net that time. That's exactly why you do that on a faceoff win. It almost gets by Tuukka Rask. Oh, wow. We'll see a couple looks at this. The overhead, you'll even see my slow-mo replay. Look at that. Nice deflection. But Tuukka Rask comes up with the save. It's still 2-1. About 6 minutes to play. Another chance rushing in here. The Blue Jackets going to put that on net. No, it hit Courtnall, but it didn't get to the net. And when it does, it's smothered. You see the upcoming games for the Blue Jackets. Another nice presentation touch here in franchise and in Be a Pro. And this game is going to expire on the Blue Jackets. They cannot get the equalizer. They lose this one 2-1 to the Boston Bruins. So a tough luck loss here in night number one in the NHL and night number one of the career for Russ Courtnall. He had chances to get that first goal, but it just didn't happen. So that's going to have to wait. You see your three stars of the game here dominated by the Bruins. They take 2 of 3, and Tuukka Rask, number one star, deservedly so. All right, so we couldn't get the win on opening night, but now we'll turn our attention to the San Jose Sharks, who did win their opening game and are 1-0 coming in to Nationwide Arena. Hopefully Nationwide is on our side tonight as we take on the Sharks and Joe Pavelski. You see him getting ready right there, conversing with teammates. And this thing is underway just early on in the first period here, about a minute and change in. There's a chance for Courtnall. That's going to be saved as well. Still looking for NHL goal number one, but if he keeps shooting and keeps going to the net, good things will happen eventually. There's a goal. He did not get that tip either, but he was there in front as it goes in. Another faceoff win and another goal, this time putting Columbus out in a lead, 1-0. And the home crowd indeed likes what they see as their team has the lead. Let's not take our foot off the gas here, though. Let's use this momentum. And can we get out of the zone? Okay, just barely. Courtnall trying to get the puck, crossing the blue line. He's going to put it on net. It is the first NHL goal for Russ Courtnall, and I love the presentation as his teammates mob him. Special occasion, making it feel special, which is something that sorely was lacking in this mode in years previous. Probably one of the reasons I never really got very far with it. But Russ Courtnall mobbed by his teammates, and the puck will be thrown into the trainer here to be labeled as his first NHL goal. Love the presentation.
What a special moment, Ray. I see his friends in the crowd cheering him on. They made the trip to see him tonight, and he delivered his first goal.
Again, presentation and commentary to match. It's little things, but they add up to a lot in the immersion of playing a career mode. So I'm glad to see that. Columbus scores again, makes it 3-0. They're pouring it on here in the first period. Courtnall waiting to get on the ice, and he is going to try to join in on the D, and it's too late. That puck, actually, I think goes in on the centering attempt. I don't even think it was put in on the cross ice pass. I'll have to see what happened here. But Joe Pavelski gets his first of the season. And yeah, he's just going to throw this at the net. I think it was meant to be a pass, but it ends up off the goaltender and in. Yeah, there you go. Well, you score them however you can. And the Sharks are on the board now. Just a 3-1 deficit now. As here comes another rush for the Blue Jackets.
He throws it there. Score! He's got his second.
Courtnall scores again. He's got two in the game, and he remembers to do his signature celebration right there, which is sure to piss the Sharks off. But hey, stop him, why don't you? Second goal tonight. Oh, wow. Courtnall coming on strong now. These shots, that one, I don't know. Looked like Brizgalov could have had this. I'm sure he wishes he had this chance back, but too late. The rookie's got two markers now, and it's 4-1. Columbus in the lead. Let's see how the Sharks respond. Will they come back and get one before the first intermission? Lots of goals going in tonight. It's 4-2. We're in the second period now. That's a shot by Courtnall that's blocked, but his teammate puts it in on the rebound. That is going to be an assist, I believe, for Courtnall on the play. It's now 5-2. Fire that cannon. There we go. Cannon is getting a lot of work tonight as Cam Atkinson gets his goal to go. And, well, San Jose not going away. They're going to make it 5-3. Last couple minutes of the second period. Over the boards is Courtnall, looking for the hat trick. Oh, he's going to pass off instead. What a great pass, and it's in the net. That's a nifty play. I'm sure everybody in the building thinking Courtnall was going to shoot for that hat trick. Instead, unselfishly unloads for another assist, and Brandon Dubinsky is the recipient on this one. Nice. Quick little pass right there, just the extra pass to set up a beautiful look to a left-handed shot, and he's got that wide open portion of the net to put it home. So 6-3 in the faceoff that is immediately after that goal. Columbus, they're buzzing, they're looking for more, and oh, what a glorious chance in the slot there, but Courtnall is stopped again, looking for that hat trick. This time he takes the shot and is stopped by Brizgalov. Let's look at it again. Look at this. He's wide open for the shot, but he just can't beat him stick side. So we got another faceoff here in the third period, about halfway through. Courtnall's got the puck, looking to cycle this around. They've got the 6-3 lead. They can... Oh, he went to the net, and he had the chance for the hat trick again. And again, he is stopped, but the Blue Jackets continue with the pressure, the shot from the point, and it goes... It's now 7-3. What great offense here by the Blue Jackets all night long. And they just play keep away until David Savard buries it in the net with a rocket shot. And I'm surprised it took this long, but Brizgalov just didn't have it. He's going to get pulled right here. Yeah, what were you waiting for? It's 7-3 now. And the Blue Jackets looking for more. Buzzing around the net. It's a rebound! Another glorious chance for Courtnall's hat trick. Still working in front of the net. Savard again.
Got a piece of it with the glove. He scores. So here in his rookie season, he has got his first NHL hat trick.
This kid is going to have a lot of hats coming to him after the game. His first HT in his rookie season.
It's a hat trick for Russ Courtnall in just his second game in the NHL. He's going all Austin Matthews on it. Okay, it wasn't his debut, and it's not four goals. But hey, it's pretty impressive as the hats rain down, and once again, the team celebrates with Russ Courtnall. The rookie has pulled off quite a feat here on the rebound goal, and it's a hat trick in just his second night in the league. A hard shot by Savard leaves a juicy rebound, and Courtnall shovels it home. Going to see a little montage of his three goals here as he gets the spotlight, getting the hat trick. This one here. Just surprised him that I think that he shot it right there. And this is a sharp angle shot that Brizgalov got a piece of, but not enough. And then the rebound and the goal for number three for Russ Courtnall. It's 8-3, about 5.5 minutes to play. But you know what? How about another one? Make it 9 for the Blue Jackets, as that's a hard shot from the point on a faceoff win. 9 goals tonight. Wow. But come on, guys. Save some of those for the next game. You may need them. Watch, the next game will be a 1-0 shutout or something like that. Anyway, this one, anything but a shutout. 9-3. Columbus takes the win in a wild one. And your rookie, Russ Courtnall, definitely shows up in a big way. His first NHL goal, and then he puts in 2 more for his first NHL hat trick. What a night for Russ Courtnall. So the Blue Jackets get their first win of the season. Even that record at 1-1, your number one star, Russ Courtnall, not only did he have 3 goals, he had 3 assists. He had 6 points and factored in on 6 of their 9 goals. Amazing. What a night. So when we come back, we'll take on the 2-2 Chicago Blackhawks. They played 4 games already? My goodness. Come on back for more. Russ Courtnall, be a pro. We'll see you then. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotasFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is the place.